Okay, Wolfpack, happy Wednesday hump day. We have got a little interesting emom here. I wanted to work on some barbell cycling, and I didn't want it to be like the most challenging thing in the world. And I wanted to kind of get some different movement patterns in the emom just for practice. And then obviously we're going to be doing a bunch in the Metcon as well. So we kind of get a little practice for part B and A. And also just work on moving the barbell, some different weights, a little heavier weights than Metcons. In a smaller time domain, okay? So it's a 10-minute EMOM. Normally when we would do this, if we were building to a heavy single split jerk or building to a heavy lift, right, the reps would go down 3, 2, 1. But again, I wanted to work on some, it's a pretty low rep ranges, honestly, but just getting, again, some barbell cycling practice, some movement pattern practice, some breathing practice on the more dynamic movements, and then just getting some pressing volume as well. So these kind of obviously are going to build off of each other, and the reason I'm putting the strict press first is not necessarily for like strict press strength or for volume, but this explosive press of the barbell overhead with no legs is extremely beneficial learning how to feel that and that explosive press for getting under the bar for your push jerks and your split jerks. Okay, for a long time I actually thought doing strict press would actually make people stronger, and it probably does a little bit, but I feel like it actually works more of as like a transferable movement to other movements, right? Getting stronger in the strict press motion is actually going to impact your jerks a lot more than, say, your overhead strength. So I've kind of had a weird little, like, what is that, an epiphany or a mind-bending, blowing, whatever. You get the picture. So your goal for these three strict press is to find a weight that is challenging for three reps, but we're focusing on bar path and speed on the bar, okay? We don't want these strict presses to be like grindy threes, right? It's something that we can get set up in, pull that head back, and when we're going to press, it should be a nice, strong, smooth, boom, okay? Big, strong press overhead. Doesn't have to be like lightning fast speed, but as long as we're being aggressive in the press, there's no stick, and we're actually having some velocity on that barbell, I really think it's going to prime those fast twitch muscles in your pressing motion. It's going to help out a ton in the bottom one. So it should be no fails, no grinding reps. Should be something that you can just drive right off of the chest for three reps. Okay, so just keep it at one weight here. It doesn't need to be anything fancy. If you go way too light on the first one, you obviously add. But we're not looking for a three rep max here. Okay, this is to compound and to build into these next movements here. Okay, so three sets of three on that. We're also going to do three sets of three on our push jerks. So again, moderate and fashion, where we're working on, right, dip drive. Once that barbell lifts off our chest, that's when we utilize that fast punch that we just worked on for the strict press. Slide the feet out, catch underneath. When we stand all the way up, again, we're going to work on cycling this barbell. So we need to bring the bar down to the chest with our elbows in front. And as soon as it makes contact on the chest, we absorb that and we use that as momentum to go into the next one. So we're going to be doing that for three reps. So again, pick a challenging weight that forces you to, one, have a great rack position, two, use a ton of leg extension, and three, be fast underneath the bar as you slide and drop. Okay, if we go too light, right, you're going to be able to manipulate the barbell with improper technique. So we need to have a little bit of weight on the bar here to really force us to focus on the things that make the push jerk work. Okay. And then the most challenging one is going to be the last four sets. Three split jerks is very dynamic, right? It takes extra time because we're splitting our feet, moving them back in, going into another repetition. So again, we need to choose an appropriate weight that challenges our technique, right? Where again, we have to have a good rack position, good extension, then we have to slide our feet nice and fast. But we don't want it to be so heavy that we're getting out of balance in our split jerk. We're having to take time in between reps, right? We should again be able to lower the bar into the chest and use that rebound absorption to get above head, okay? We'll do that for three sets, so get a little pressing EMOM, okay? And then the Metcon is pretty straightforward. I think it's going to be extremely challenging. I guess it kind of just depends on how much you want to challenge yourself and how many burpees you want to do. So how's this going to work? You're going to do a 400-meter run as a buy-in, right? This is obviously going to fatigue the heart rate. It's going to fatigue the posterior chain for our clean and jerks. Okay, so we're going to do 30 clean and jerks. And every time you drop the bar, you're going to do 5 bar facing burpees. And it's going to start with 5 bar facing burpees. So you do 400-meter run, come in, do 5 burpees, stand up, grab the bar, and once you get it going, right, you're going to power clean it, you're going to push jerk it above head, take the bar down to the ground, tap the floor, power clean, push jerk. Say you do 10. Great. Drop the bar, do 5 burpees, pick it back up. Say you do 8, get to 18, drop the bar, 5 burpees, and you're going to complete that until you get to 30 clean and jerks. Okay, so we need to have a weight on the bar that you could probably do at least 10 on the first set, okay? Because this 400-meter run obviously is going to fatigue the posterior chain. Once you do one set here, everything's going to be blown up. Grip, shoulders, heart rate, and posterior chain, okay? So we need to make sure we have a weight that we can get a big chunk out of the way on the first one, at least 10, that we can chip away at 5s and 6s or whatever it may be, okay? That way we're getting this workout done in a decent time domain and there's still some intensity, okay? If we're doing 5s, on these clean and jerks, we're going to end up doing, what, a ton of extra burpees, 30 extra burpees. And this workout is not about the burpees. We want it to be big sets on the clean and jerk. Just wanted to add a little bit of a penalty for the burpees. Okay, so choose an appropriate weight on that. And once you've completed the 30, drop the bar. You don't have to do the burpees once you've completed the 30s. And then you have to try to hobble your way through a 400-meter run when your posterior chain is smoked. And it's going to be super awesome to see you guys run this and have a little fun. So if we're looking for a time to chase, right, a couple minutes on the run, over-exaggerated, 2.5 minutes, right? If we're able to do, 10 per minute plus your burpees, okay, you're looking at 90 seconds, maybe, call it, and that's going to take you, 4.5, 5 minutes, 7, run, 9, 10, probably going to be somewhere between a 10 and 15-minute workout. So other than that, excited for you guys. Have a great Wednesday. See you in the gym. Bye.